Hi, I'm Gary. This is my new channel. I'm going to go through how we set up pfSense. It's just an amazing tool. I've been using it on my home network for a while. We was going to use it in my previous job until I had to leave. So let's get into it, shall we? So I'm going to assume that you've already downloaded and put pfSense on a USB stick. Links will be in the description for that. This is now booting from that USB stick. Just let it just run through the startup. And we'll agree to the EULA and we'll get to the install. So click on install, choose your keyboard layout. I'm in the UK. Continue with that. Always try to use ZFS if you can. Let's go with a UEFI boot. Select your disk and let it do it. So while that's fetching the distribution from over the network, we'll just carry on with this while it does that. Shouldn't take too long. Almost done now. There we go. Just extracting it. This is installing to a nice fresh hard drive, or in this case, an SSD. Should be fairly quick. This is in real time, so you'll see how quickly it does it. And there we go. Done. So there's nothing else we want to do at this stage. So, nope. And reboot. While that's rebooting, there we go, first boot. There we go, and that's it. So pfSense is now installed on this machine. As you can see, this is actually running in a VM on Hyper-V. I do have this running on my real network on an appliance, but for the purposes of this video, we're going to do it on here. Let's not worry about VLANs for now. We won't worry about the WAN interface for now either, purely because we don't care about that. We just want to get to the web interface. Yep. So there we go. So if you'll see, it's now got a WAN IP address, which we don't care about at the moment because we're not going to access it and anything through this one. It's just literally to show you how to set it up. Starting its DNS resolvers and starting the web configurator. That's what we're going to access after this is done. So there we go. So by default, pfSense will set itself up as a 192.168.1.1, which is a bit curious because, you know, not the greatest. So what we're going to do is we're going to quickly change the IP address of that so that we can access it over the network. So set IP interfaces, which is number 2. And we want the LAN, which is option 2. Now, this will be different depending on your network. So if you're on a 192.168.0 or 1 address, put in what is free on your network. So if 192.168.0.150 is free, use that for now. We can always change that later if we need to. I'm going to go with .251 because I know there's nothing up there. And it's a /23. Yours is probably a /24. We don't want to set up a DHCP server. We will do, but we don't want to do that right now. So there we go. pfSense should now be accessible on your network. And there it is, 251. So we'll proceed. It's got a self-signed certificate at the moment. We're not going to worry too much about that. So if it comes up with a warning message, just accept that. Default login is admin and pfSense. And here we go. So we'll get a nice little wizard. We'll just quickly run through that. Call it whatever you like. Set whatever DNS servers you want to use. Let's go with Google and 1111. Select our time zone. Like I said, I'm in the UK. Skip past all of this for now. There's my LAN IP address. And this is where we get to choose a nice new password. So make it nice and secure for yourselves. There we go. That's that. It's just going to reload the web configurator, and it's done. So that's how you quickly install pfSense, nice and easily. It's just going to take us to the home page now, and we'll get a nice little notice that we never really read, and thank you. So there we go. So there's our two network interfaces. Because it's a virtual machine on Hyper-V, it's telling me that it's 10 gig. It's not, it's 1 gig, but anyway, that doesn't matter. So we're on the latest version, which is based on FreeBSD 12.2. And that's pretty much it for the install. Let's just put in some quick graphs, shall we? Traffic graphs, there we go. And there we go. So we can see that already there is traffic on these two interfaces. Not that that makes much difference at this point. So in the next video, I'll run through a few things. More advanced setups. As this is configured right now, it is quite secure. So you've got your two interfaces. If we go to firewall rules, you'll see nothing is allowed into the network. And everything is allowed out, which is something we can shore up in a later one. So once we've got through to this point, we are now ready to go and you can start using it. I've been Gary. Thanks. I'll see you in the next video.